Testing thumb MP flexion. Your patient's hand will be in a supinated position, resting on a table or flat surface. First thing you'll have your patient do is bring their thumb all the way across their palm, but keeping the distal part of their thumb extended. Go ahead and do that for me, Rachel. Now bring it back. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 3. Now, because she was able to do that, I proceed forward to see if she can test for a 4 or 5. So I will have her perform that about halfway again, about right there. I will stabilize the first metacarpal here, and then I will add resistance to the proximal phalanx of the thumb here. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1. There we go. So according to how her resistance is, I'd grade that as a 4 or a 5. You can bring your thumb back. If she could not bring her thumb into full range of motion while in this position without resistance, then I will have her in a gravity minimized or gravity eliminated position, as shown here. So go ahead, Rachel. What I want you to do is bring your thumb as close to the table as possible, and then come back up. Because she's able to do that, that'd be a grade 2. If she could not do that, or if there was minimal motion going on, then I would palpate the flexor pollicis brevis, which is found about right here. If I feel this muscle firing, that would be a grade 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that would be a grade 0. Testing thumb MP extension. You'll have your patient's hand in a neutral position while resting on a flat surface or a table as shown here. The first thing you'll have your patient do is extend their thumb towards the ceiling as far as they can go and bring it back down. Because she was able to do that at this joint, this is the joint we're looking at here, the MP joint, we would grade that as a 3. To test for 4 and 5, I will stabilize the first metacarpal and apply resistance to the proximal phalanx. But first, have your patient go downward with their thumb about this way, and then have them come up and do extension. So resist me, 3, 2, 1. If the patient cannot bring their thumb into full extension while in gravity eliminated position as shown here, if they can only come up, you know, halfway or whatever, we will grade that as a 2 because there's no gravity eliminated position for this extension. If they cannot do any movement in of extension at this joint while in this position, then that will be a 1, and you will palpate for the extensor pollicis brevis, which is found just distal to the MC joint here, because that's where it attaches at. If you feel any movement, that is a 1, and if you do not feel any movement happening at that joint, that is a 0. Testing thumb IP flexion. You will have your patient's hand in a supinated position on a flat surface or table as shown here. First thing you will have your patient do is to curl their thumb inward into their palm as much as they can go. Okay, now bring it back out. Because she's able to do that, I would grade her as a 3. I will now proceed forward to test for a 4 or a 5. The first thing I will do is I will stabilize the proximal phalanx of her thumb, and I will apply resistance to the distal phalanx of her thumb while having her perform this position about halfway. So go about halfway in range. Okay, I'll apply resistance, so go ahead, resist me. 3, 2, 1. If she could not bring her thumb into flexion while in this position, then you can have her in a gravity eliminated position. But keep in mind, the thumb is very small, and you're not really eliminating that much gravity. But anyway, that's besides the point. So you'll have her in this position, and you will ask the patient to curl their thumb towards the ground as far as they can go. And because she's able to do this, that would be a grade 2. If there is minimal movement, then you will palpate for the flexor pollicis longus tendon. Now, why I'm palpating for the tendon movement is because, if you remember your anatomy, the muscle belly of this muscle is all the way in the forearm. So I want to see right here the tendon in the proximal phalanx to see if there's any movement. If I feel movement, that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel any movement, it's totally stagnant, that is a grade 0.
Testing
thumb IP extension, you'll have your patient's hand in a neutral rotation, resting on a flat surface of table as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is extend their thumb upwards into extension as far as they can go, so towards the ceiling. There you are. Now, as she's here, I'm looking at this joint right here, the IP, seeing how much extension she has while extending her full thumbward, her full thumb upward. Okay, now let rest back down, Rachel. Now, if I'm going to get more specific at this joint, what I'm going to do is I'm going to stabilize the proximal phalanx, and I'm going to add resistance to the distal phalanx. So Rachel, what I want you to do is kind of have your thumb a little bit in flexion for me. Okay, now I want you to extend it upwards and resist me. 3, 2, 1. Depending on the resist that she gives me, I will rate that as a 4 or a 5. If she cannot do it in full range of motion, then I will rate that as a 2. If there's minimal movement into extension, I will palpate the extensor pollicis longus, which can be palpated in two areas. One area will be just distal to the IP joint here. You palpate there, or you can palpate just right here behind the thumb to test for any movement whatsoever. If you feel movement, that is a 1, and if you do not feel movement, that is a 0. Testing palmar abduction, also known as thumb abduction. Patient will be in a seated position with the hand in a supinated position. First thing you will have your patient do is perform thumb abduction towards the ceiling. So go ahead and do that, Rachel, as far as you can go, and bring it on down. Because she was able to do that, I would count that as a grade 3. And because she did that, I would proceed forward to grade for a 4 or 5. So how I would do that is I'd have the patient bring their thumb into the same position, but only halfway. I would stabilize the forearm just proximal to the wrist, and then I will add resistance to the thumb just proximal to the MP joint here. Okay, Rachel, I want you to resist me. 3, 2, 1. Very good, bring it down. If she could not bring her thumb into abduction, then I would have her in a gravity eliminated position. Looks like this, shown here. Go ahead and perform thumb abduction for me, Rachel, and then bring it back. Because she was able to perform this, I would count that as a grade 2. If she could not, then I would palpate this muscle right here, which is the abductor pollicis brevis. If I feel that muscle firing, that'd be a grade 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0. Testing thumb radial abduction, also known as CMC extension. Patient's hand will be on a flat surface or table in a neutral position, thumb resting on the second digit. First thing you'll have your patient do is perform thumb extension towards the ceiling as far as they can go. Bring it back down. Because she was able to do this, that is a grade 3. I will now proceed to test for a 4 or 5. So first thing you'll have your patient do is go back into extension about halfway. I will stabilize on the forearm just proximal to the CMC joint of the thumb, and then I will place resistance just distal of the CMC joint right here. Okay, Rachel, I want you to resist me. 3, 2, 1. And release. Good job. If she could not bring her thumb into extension against gravity position, I would have her in a gravity eliminated position. And all that is simply having the palm downward on the table and have it letting the thumb slide on across the table into an extension, and then now bring it back. If your patient's able to do this, then that is a grade 2. If they cannot, then I would palpate the abductor pollicis longus. Actually, it's found back here. I'll be palpating this tendon. If I feel this tendon sliding or attempting to slide any movement here, then that would be a grade 1. If I do not feel anything happening here, that would be a grade 0. Testing thumb adduction, you'll have the patient's hand in a pronated position hanging off the table as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is bring their thumb downward and then bring it back into adduction. Because she's able to do this, this is a grade 3. Now to test for a 4 and 5, you want to keep in mind that we are testing the CMC joint back here. So I want to be careful about crossing too many joints up here when I'm applying resistance. So first, I'm going to stabilize the wrist, and then I'm going to add resistance as close to this joint as possible. So I'll be about right here. So bring your thumb down about halfway, Rachel, about right there. And then I want you to bring your thumb into adduction while I bring you into abduction. So go ahead and resist me. 3, 2, 1. Now to test for the thumb adduction in a gravity eliminated position, you'll have the patient's hand in a neutral position resting on a solid surface as shown here. First thing you'll have your patient do is bring their thumb outward and then see if they can bring it back towards their palm. So go ahead and do that, Rachel. Because she was able to do that, that'd be a grade 2. If she could not, then I would palpate the adductor pollicis, which is found right in this web space right here. If I feel this muscle firing or movement there, that will be a grade 1. And if I do not feel any movement, that'd be a grade 0. Testing thumb-finger opposition. Patient's hand will be on a flat surface or table with the palm facing the ceiling. Rachel, I want you to touch the tip of your thumb to the tip of your pinky for me. Because she's able to perform this range of motion, we know that she's at least a grade level 3. Go ahead, bring those back for me. Now go about halfway, just about to touch to each other. Okay, now I will apply resistance to the thenar eminence here and to the hypothenar eminence here. So go ahead and resist me, Rachel. 3, 2, 1, 0. Very good. Now, if she was not able to perform full range of motion, so go ahead, Rachel, bring that up and pretend like you cannot touch those together. Now, if you can not touch the pinky and the thumb together, we would grade that as a level 2. And if she cannot perform any range of motion whatsoever, I would palpate for the opponent's digiti minimi, which is here, and the opponent's pollicis, which is up here on the thumb. And when I palpate these, if I feel any muscle firing, then that is a grade 1. And if I do not feel any firing, that is a grade 0.